Be Wise as Serpents by Fritz Springmeier. Continues. Chapter 1 Who Built Your Frame of Reference? Continues. Chapter 1.06 The Emerald Island. You will learn the importance of bloodlines in relation to the power. About the bloodline of Charles T. Russell, founder of the Watchtower Society. Bloodlines, they can mean authority, such as royal lineages, they can mean power, occult wisdom and power is generationally passed down in Satanists, they can mean like-mindedness, world views are learned to a great extent from our parents, similar physical brains are genetically inherited, for instance, identical twins separated at birth, and rejoined at adulthood are found to have surprising similarities in modes of behavior. Today the principles of racial heredity are not popular at the public educational institutions controlled by the power. Also supposedly, royalty is a thing of the past and aristocracy is fading with it. After thousands of hours of research on the power, one thing is blatantly clear: the power resides in bloodlines that pass authority, occult power, and knowledge, and like-minded worldviews from generation to generation. Bloodlines have not ceased to be important. The process to identifying the power. In researching the power behind hundreds of individuals and groups, it has been like peeling the layers of an onion. Which men and women are front men, lackeys, and hirelings, and which ones are really running the show and making decisions. For instance, men like Anton Levy, George Bush, William Buckley, the major networks news anchormen, although powerful in their own right, are in the overall picture front men. There is an elite, not only in the United States, or Great Britain, or Russia, but an elite over the entire globe. Surprising? When the astute observer begins to realize that an oligarchy is running the world, then there are lackeys in academia to tell us we should not have been surprised. Robert Michaels concluded that elitism is a natural thing of society, because society required organization and all organizations are oligarchies, even socialist societies. That elites are inevitable is debatable, the elites are actually unproductive parasites on society, but this is not likely to be debated in today's population, which have been conditioned by the elites' media to be sheep. It was debated by the USS founding fathers, who set up an alternative to an oligarchy or a democracy, by establishing a republic. Although there are societies, even somewhat modern ones, without oligarchies, which prove that a community can function without some self-perpetuating power elite, these societies are not in control of the world. The power that is in control of the world is not the benevolent, wise and spiritual group some of the masses have been conditioned by behavior modification to believe. This book intends to expose that world power, and that means attempting to expose the bloodlines that have savagely maintained their parasitic power. Important bloodlines for the power include: the Jewish bloodline of the Pruer de Zion, which starts with the tribe of Dan, extends through the Merovingian dynasty and into the Habsburg royalty. This bloodline has kept a close association with all branches of the occult, often providing the leadership for the occult. The bloodlines of the leaders of the LDS and RLDS churches, which go back to the bloodline of the Pruer de Zion, the Merovingians. A secret society of Danites was created by the LDS church. The bloodlines of the 13 Illuminati families, which include several Jewish and Marano's Jewish families. The bloodlines of the petty Hasidic Jewish messiahs that began their religious reigns in Poland among the Ashkenazim. The bloodlines of the Babylonish Talmudic Jews. Historical evidence shows these bloodlines were of mixed blood even in Christ's time, in disregard for the scripture's commandments not to mix blood. The bloodlines of the successors of the Messiah. That is the bloodline of the Sufi leadership. The bloodlines of the Knights of Malta. The aristocratic / royal bloodlines carry titles, wealth, and power. The bloodlines of the descendants of William of Orange and those who helped him conquer England. They have been in powerful positions since, especially in England. Part of William of Orange's help was derived from those of Jewish descent. The bloodlines of the 13 Illuminati families, which have tie-ins to the bloodlines above. These 13 are not a fixed set, but because of their power, change in who are the 13 doesn't often occur. A tentative list of these 13 families includes Astor, Bundy, Collins, DuPont, Freeman, Lee, Onassis, Rockefeller, Rothschild, and Van Dyne. Besides those families, there are a host of other families that are important within the Illuminati. The list includes those of German Jewish heritage: Adler, Geisenheimer, Goldschmidt, Guggenheim, Lazard, Oppenheim, Oppenheimer, Seligman, Sichel, Speyer, Stern, Russell, Wolf, E., and those of British or Scottish heritage: Akison, Bell, Billings, Brown, Buckland, Clinton, Eddy, Frost, Gardner, Hall, Hopkins, Hooker, Kennedy, Leake, Lord, Morgan, Sinclair, St. Clair, Smith, Tolkien, Llewellyn, and others such as Habsburgs, Sassoons. What makes this study of vital and timely importance is that members of these bloodlines intend within the seven-year period of 1992 to 1999 to launch a sequence of events to lead the world into a one-world slave state ruled by a man controlled by the god which the elites worship. Should the reader allow, I will quote from the power's own statements plus other proof to show that this god, the god of the world, is Lucifer, aka Satan, Sanat, Venus, etc. For thousands of years, the plan for world domination has been passed down from occult generation to occult generation. Spaced every 20 years plus is a Feast of the Beast, a year-long holiday during which Satanists receive new instructions from Satan on how to carry out the plan. We read of the Great Holiday and its great councils in Externalization of the Hierarchy, when Satan's instrument Alice Bailey writes, "The past year has, however, been the year in which the greatest spiritual approach of all time has shown itself to be possible, an approach for which the initiates and masters have for centuries been preparing, and for which all the Wesak festivals since the meeting of the Great Council in 1925 have been preparatory. I have, in past instructions, referred to the great meetings held at intervals by those to whom is entrusted the spiritual guidance of the planet and particularly of man." Externalization of the Hierarchy, page 389. One sample of their plans as example of how ingenious these plans are to create a one-world government: consider the following part of it. The drug war is not what it seems. It is a very ingenious scheme to enslave the American people, and destroy all their civil rights. The first rumblings of the drug war part of the plan seem to stir from the occult, so it is highly possible the drug war originally was first developed by Satanists, perhaps even given during one of the Feasts of the Beast. The drug war seems like the perfect plan, with no way for the power to lose. First, the power creates a drug culture in America. The drug culture would and did give many their first step into the Aquarian, New Age, conspiracy. 5. The power would make billions of dollars by running drugs, to further finance other nefarious schemes, and could use their worldwide power to crush all their competitors. When the power crushed and arrested their competitors in drug running, they would be hailed as heroes by the majority of people. And they have. The introduction of drugs into society does several things. It taxes the Christian church's ability to oppose immorality. It gets the public indignant about drugs, and the public's moral outcry allows the power to pass drug laws that remove the last vestiges of legal civil rights. In fact, the beguiled public demands the laws which abolish their rights, and applauds these laws in ignorance, unknowing what the laws actually say and mean. If the public somehow gets a complete picture that their government has been smuggling drugs to create a drug war in spite of the controlled media, or perhaps through the media at the right time, then they can create a scandal involving several U.S. presidents to eliminate the U.S. government and switch the public's allegiance to a world government. See Chapter 3.9 for more details and a chronology of the secretly planned escalation of today's designed drug war. As an ex-Mason, who is very aware of their plans, said to this author, "These people are in it for the long term." The bloodline of the Russells. The purpose of this next subsection may be misunderstood, unless I make myself clear at this point. This author has not established any link between the various famous Russells. Although I have been doing genealogy work, I have not had the chance to do the long-term genealogy work required to clarify the issue. If the reader is dissatisfied with the extent of this information, he is encouraged that rather than criticize to research it himself. The reader will observe by the time he finishes this book, that this author has done extensive research into many groups. One item that has popped up consistently is that people with the surname Russell repeatedly appear as important figures in the various elements of the world order as it has developed. Before becoming aware of the One World Order, this author had no inkling how important bloodlines have been for the elite that controls the world. Friendships have also played a role. For instance, Eleanor Roosevelt, who was involved in numerous communist organizations, was a close friend and confidant to Ronald Reagan's mother. This seems trivial, but the reoccurrence of bloodlines and the recurrent discovery of connections of friendships between what have been thought of as unrelated personages, compels one to believe the elite is more compact than appears. More on that later. The mysterious Watchtower Society and its founder Charles Taz Russell will serve as perhaps the most used example in this book of an organization that is secretly serving the New World Order. The reader will be presented with the history of all this throughout the book, especially in chapters 5 to 17 of the first section. Let's comment about the type of Russells that keep appearing throughout the course of the history of the New World Order as this author went about his research. To summarize, these various Russells, who until the genealogy work is done to show the connections should be viewed as individuals not a group, have been prominent members of the Illuminati, the Masons, the Fabians, the Mormons, the Jehovah's Witnesses, the Jesuits, the Royal Society, and the media controlled by those of the New World Order, and a deputy chairman of the Federal Reserve. Typically they have been merchants and lawyers, with a fair share of them also as Christian heretics. It will be easier perhaps to illustrate how the Russells keep popping up in the New World Order storyline by listing a good sampling of them. Sample of Russells of interest. Russells who founded fraternal societies. William Huntington Russell, founder of what is believed to be an American chapter of the Illuminati, Skull and Bones Order, 0.7. More on this in chapter 2.3. Its legal name is Russell Trust. John Russell, founder of the Fraternity of Daughters of Isabella, DOI, in May 1897, in New Haven Con. 8 Russells connected to fraternal organizations. Charles Taz Russell, Knights Templar Mason of York Rite, in Allegheny, PA, and founder of the Watchtower Society. 9 Harvey D. Russell, K.T. Mason, leader of Pittsburgh, PA Beaver Valley Lodge No. 8410. John Russell, pastor C.T. Russell's stepmother was executor of his will. His mother was the one chosen to dance with famous Mason and Illuminatus Lafayette when he was in Philadelphia. 11 William H. Russell Mason and part owner of the Pony Express, which was a firm made up mainly of Masons. 12 George William Russell, 1869-1935, leading member of the Dublin Theosophist Lodge, wrote art for the Theosophic periodical The Irish Theosophist. Initiated into the Lodge of Isis, with its sexual rites. The keynote of his work is from the Bhagavad Gita. He was a good friend of Golden Dawn leader William Butler Yeats, who wrote some of the satanic Masonic rituals for the Golden Dawn. 13 James Russell, president of the Royal Society of Edinburgh, which was associated with esoteric groups like the Masons. 14 Archibald D. Russell, 1811-1871, a Presbyterian Mason who graduated from the University of Edinburgh, Scott. He studied at the University of Bonn, GER, and was active in setting up various organizations in the United States. 15 Benjamin Russell, 1761-1845, Mason and early American journalist. 16 Charles H. Russell, governor of Nevada, 1950-58, and 32 degree Mason, also in the York Rite, and a Shriner. 17 J. Stuart Russell Mason and newspaper editor and deputy chairman of the Fed Reserve Bank in Chicago. 18 Lee M. Russell, 1875-1943, Mason and L.T. Government of Miss. 1916-20.19 Louis A. Russell, 1854-1925, Mason, organist for South Park Presbyterian Church, Newark, N.J. 20 Richard B. Russell, 1861-1938, Mason, judge, editor and business exec. 21 Richard B. Russell, Jr. Mason and Government of Georgia, 1931-33 and senior from Georgia since 1933. 22 Before going to our next section, would be worthwhile to cover the family that Bertrand Russell came from. They hold the title of Dukes of Bedford. Ordo W. Russell served in Lord Palmerston's office from 1850 to 52. He served as unofficial ambassador for Great Britain to the Vatican from 1857 to 70. His son Baron Amptill was Grand Master of the English Masons 1908 to 1935. He joined the English equivalent of the Knights of Malta, that is the Order of St. John of Jerusalem, and served as the Grand Master of the Lodge formed at the Bank of England. He was appointed head of the Indian Masons of Madras, India, home of the Theosophical Society. Ordo Russell's son also served in some high political positions. Russell's connected to groups that tie back to the Illuminati, see future chapters such as 2.5, Charles Edward Russell, Jewish socialist who worked for NY. Life controlled by J.P. Morgan, and also for NY. Tribune and Herald. 23 James E. Russell, Columbia University professor who introduced Wundt's Hegelian philosophy to his students at Columbia. 24 Thomas Russell, 1767-1803, a revolutionist of the Illuminati stream of revolution. 25 Samuel Russell represented Baring Brothers. Helped open up the port of Shanghai for the international financiers. 26 Bertrand Russell, famous Fabian socialist, and one worlder. 27 Alice Russell, ex-eccentric Quaker, wife of Bertrand and also a Fabian socialist. 28 Rev. Matthew Russell, 1834-1912, Jesuit writer. 29 Russell's connected in some way to the IBSA, now called Jehovah's Witnesses. Charles Taz Russell, senior pastor. Russell's uncle, broker, and real estate agent. 30 Moses F. Russell, postmaster of Saltillo, Hopkins Co. TX near where Hayden Cooper Covington's parents moved. 31 Brother Russell, an early elder of the Belfast, Ireland IBSA congregation. 32 Russell's connected in some way to Mormonism. Elder Isaac Russell, a prominent early Mormon missionary to Great Britain in 1837. 33 Captain Joseph H. Russell, original investor in stock in the Mormon Deseret Manufacturing Co., which was intended to be an umbrella company for many early Mormon enterprises. 34 The Russell who opened a store with Mormon blessings in the newly created Salt Lake City. The store was called Miller, Russell & Co., a branch of Russell, Majors, and Waddell, and was a primary source of goods in the area of Utah. 35 Other Russells. Baron Charles Russell, 1832-1900, solicitor, lawyer, in Ulster and advocate for Ireland. 36 Jerome Russell, a Grey Friar, burned in 1539 for heresy with John Kennedy in Glasgow, Scot. 37 Philemon R. Russell, editor of the Christian Herald and Journal, in the March 19, 1840 issue he stressed 2520 years in prophecy, which was an idea C.T. Russell would later pick up and promote. William Howard Russell, First War correspondent for London's The Times newspaper in 1854. The London Times has long been part of the world order. That William was the first of his kind is quite significant. Notes 1. Michaels, Robert. Political Parties, A Sociological Study of the Oligarchical Tendencies of Modern Democracy. ORIG 1915. Reprint, New York, Free Press, 1962, page 72. This subject is very controversial. One of the few books even willing to touch the subject in a scholarly biblical manner is Crawford, Jerah B. Last Battle Cry, Christianity's Final Conflict with Evil. Knoxville, TN, Jan Publishing, 1986. Although I don't concur with all of Crawford's conclusions, the book shows more than enough evidence to support the point superscribed. 3. Confidential source personally involved with the IT. 4. The documentation to show that the drug war is a contrived scheme is extensive. I have chosen to place some of the documentation much further back, but will state that several researchers give seminars exposing it in detail. The Vietnam War was an important part of the scheme, and since then some of the recent important laws passed to implement this contrived war are PL 99-570, page L100-690, and the Omnibus Crime Bill in 1991. 5. Marilyn Ferguson, New Age writer, states in her famous book The Aquarian Conspiracy, page 90, LSD gave a whole generation a religious experience. But chemical satori is perishable, its effects too overwhelming to integrate into everyday life. Non-drug psychotechnologies offer a controlled, sustained movement toward that spacious reality. The annals of the Aquarian Conspiracy are full of accounts of passages, LSD to Zen, LSD to India, psilocybin to psychosynthesis. 6. Checks by the FBI and other federal agencies confirmed this. 7. Sutton, Anthony. America's Secret Establishment. Billings, M.T., Liberty House Press, 1986, pages 5, 6, 835, 66-67, 100, 212, 253. 8. Schmidt, Greenwood. Encyclopedia of American Institutional Fraternal Organizations. Westport, Conn., Greenwood Press, 1980, page 84. 9. Various Christians have seen Charles T. Russell's KT membership records, which are filed in the Mother Lodge in Ireland. The connections between his beliefs and his actions as the Watchtower Society's leader and the Masons is the subject of my previous book, The Watchtower and the Masons. 10. Proceedings of the 90th Annual Conclave held in the city of Harrisburg, Dauphin County. Pa, Knights Templars, 1943, page 114. 11. This information is compiled from research from several sources. A. Nevin, Adelaide Mellier. The Social Mirror, a character sketch of the women of Pittsburgh and vicinity during the first century of the county's existence. Society of Today. Pittsburgh, Pa., T.A. Nevin Publisher, 1888, page 19, B. The Pittsburgh Directory, 1878-79, showing Elizabeth the widow of John, and C. John Russell in the 1850 census, and John Russell's will. 12. Denslow, 10,000 Famous Freemasons, Volume 4, page 82. William H. Russell is also mentioned in the New Age magazine, June, 1963, page 45. 13. This information comes from several sources, including A. Boylan, Henry. A Dictionary of Irish Biography. New York, St. Martin's Press, 1988, page 345, B. Ancient Wisdom and Secret Sex, Time Life, 1989, p.154. 1415. Denslow, OPCIT, page 80. 16. Ibid 17. Ibid 18. Ibid 19. Ibid 20. Denslow, OPCIT, page 82-21. Ibid 22. Ibid 23. Biography of Americans. 24. Sutton, Anthony C. America's Secret Establishment. Billington, M.T., Liberty House, page 84. 25. Boylan, Henry. A Dictionary of Irish Biography. New York, St. Martin's Press, 1988, page 345. 26. Mullins, Eustace. The World Order. Stanton, V.A., Ezra Pound Institute of Civilization, 1985, page 92. 27. The Fabians. 28. Ibid 29. Boylan, Henry. A Dictionary of Irish Biography. New York, St. Martin's Press, 1988, page 345. 30. Springmeier, Fritz. The Watchtower and the Masons, pages 9, 215. 31. Author's Genealogical Research in Hopkins Co. TX History. 32. Early Convention Report. 33. Evans, Richard L. A Century of Mormonism in Great Britain. Salt Lake City, UT, Publishers Press, 1937, pages 34-35. 34. Gibbons, Francis M. John Taylor, Mormon Philosopher, Prophet of God. Salt Lake City, UT, Deseret Books, 1985, page 129. 35. Utah Historical Quarterly, 1941, Salt Lake City, pages 190-211. 36. Boylan, OPCIT, page 344-37. Ibid, and Black, George F. The Surnames of Scotland. New York, The New York Public Library, 1962, page 705. Questioning old assumptions, there was enough circumstantial evidence to lead one to question several assumptions. I began to question the assumption that the WT presidents were unconnected to each other. Another supposition that was questionable was that the Watchtower Society did not have a hidden agenda. C.T. Russell's story. Once there was a Jewish family whose name was Russell. They lived in early 17th century Germany. They moved to a country called Scotland. There they respelled the name Russell. They took on the ways of their new homeland. The English tried to settle Protestants from Scotland in Ireland in order to control the Irish. When the opportunity opened up to go to the Emerald Island, Ireland, with the Scottish settlers who went to the plantation Ulster, they went. It is possible, but not known for sure, that they learned to know the Rutherfords either in Scotland or Ireland. Scotland repeatedly appears as the source of much of the religious heresy connected with the power. That C.T. Russell's family were in Scotland for a period, and also from the German states, which seem to be a hotbed for Jewish Satanism, may be only a coincidence, and then again it might be a clue to understanding the origins of the Watchtower Society. This author's previous book, The Watchtower and the Masons, tells the story how the Arian heresy began at the University of Edinburgh, Scotland, and spread to the Presbyterians of the Synod of Ulster. The book gives this author's reasons for believing that the C.T. Russell's family in Northern Ireland were Arian in belief before coming to the U.S., and chances are they were involved with Freemasonry also. The Ackley connection in The Watchtower and the Masons. The early history of C.T. Russell is given. Charles and his father married two Ackley sisters a number of years after Charles's mother died. What is an intriguing item is that C.T. Russell's mother's will indicates she owned land in Iowa. A description of that land shows it was north of the town of Ackley, Iowa. It turns out that a man named William Ackley had purchased the land in that area, and had sold it in large part to Scot-Irish settlers of the Presbyterian faith as they were coming to America. At the time C.T. Russell's mother died, a town named Ackley had been staked out in 1857, but the Civil War had interfered with construction plans. A Presbyterian congregation had been formed in the area during the early 1860s in the Ackley area, which indicates some settlers had arrived. What connection did the Russells have with the Ackleys years before Charles T. and his father married Ackley sisters? Who are the Ackleys? Maria Ackley, who was Charles T. Russell's wife, was well-educated and an excellent writer. Interestingly, in the 19th century she believed a socialist revolution was coming. She wrote, "This great revolution has not yet come, but where is the statesman or the intelligent citizen that does not see it coming?" Russell, Maria. This Gospel of the Kingdom, page 26. She was the ghost writer and ghost editor for much of her husband Charles Taz's work. Her family was well off. William Ackley, the land speculator slash seller in Iowa, traces his ancestry back to Prince Doane and Elizabeth Godfrey. Elizabeth Godfrey in turn was the great-granddaughter of William Brewster of the Mayflower fame. The Ackleys were Puritans to begin with and seem to have been concentrated in the Connecticut area, and from there their family members moved out into New York and PA. Another Ackley, 1832-1881, at that time was Richard Thomas Ackley, a Freemason who worked for the Miller, Russell, and Company store in Salt Lake City in 1858, soon after the Mormons built Salt Lake City. Leads, of course, these are all simply tantalizing leads for the investigator, but nothing solid. There seems to be much more to Charles Taz Russell than the little that the public has been told. In the next few chapters, we will attempt to dispel some of the mystery surrounding the man.